Whoops. Nope. We gotta do this right. Come on. Here we go. See? Smooth. Went just fine. Everything's fine here. We're all just great. Except for Butt won't connect to Alpha Geek Radio, which is unfortunate. Oh, because it's trying to do Alpha Geek Radio 3. So let's do 1, see what happens. Oh, hey! Oh, hi there!
Oh, hi.
All right. I don't know if the falsetto's there this evening. I'm gonna have to give a throat massage with a cock. I need a little dick in my throat. Here we go. There we go. Yes, Carl will. Bonnie will be with us. Amazing photo of MC Allergy. Some music thing I gotta get ready. Wow, this is just a straight up Tekken ending. Those were the days. Let me play this over here. All right. Did somebody cut this together? Oh, yeah.
Your help. Please call the number on your screen or go online and join the BCSPCA with a monthly gift right now. For just $18 a month, you'll rescue animals from their abusers, provide medical care, food, shelter, and love. Call or join online in the next 30 minutes and we'll send you the photo of an animal in the shelter and this beautiful tote bag. Free. This is your chance to say, I won't sit by while an animal suffers. Kiss me gently into morning, for the night has been unkind. Please call or go online right now.
Yep, 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 yep. No way. Tilly, is this real? Shut up.
Each of the four Gospels in the New Testament tells the story of how Jesus, while he was out sermonizing in a remote location, fed 5,000 men plus not worth recording additional women and children. All this with only 5 bread loaves and 2 fish. At the end of the meal, his disciples... Yeah,
okay. Totally going to save it for the show. That's too good. That one goes straight into the bank. The wind from my butt when I fuck. Oh, yeah, sorry about that. That sucks. That super sucks. You look really bad in front of people. I do that every Tuesday night.
I think most people appreciate the fact that you'll just be open and honest rather than, you know, putting you down by saying, well, don't ask silly questions. I would say that if you asked something I thought was a silly question. I would just...
All right, here we go. When did you first use a flush toilet?
Don't ask silly questions. Are you serious?
5 minutes long about her poop. Oh, yeah.
Well, you know, I was laughing the other night about something. I guess my aunt had a toilet in the bathroom, and we were so fascinated. You know, we were afraid. I was afraid to use it. You know, I mean, I just thought it was going to just suck us right down. It was just really weird. She also had the first television we ever saw, too.
How old were you when you first...
Yeah, we get it. You're poor as fuck. And you brought a lot of money and did a lot of good for the mountains of Tennessee. Yes, but...
I never work a day in my life. I just lay back and let the big beat lead me. I never work a day in my life. I just lay back and let the big...
Oh, Jesus.
I just lay back and let the big...
Yep, that's definitely a dude's part. I don't want to sit there and picture your sphincter flopping around.
I'm not going to debate that with Andre because he knows very well that this is just... taking advantage of the advantage that he might have in terms of spreading his own propaganda. The bottom line is that we also have a responsibility to ensure that whatever decisions are taken are based on scientific evidence that is available, for which we have employed the researchers to do the necessary for us.
All right, well, Andrew, I'm not sure if you have any closing comments.
I think that's all I got to say.
Well played, sir. Destiny, something weird on Venus Patrol. What? These guys better be doing like an actual live performance with choreographed dance.
If I could escape, I would, but first of all, let me say I must apologize for...
Dude, I used to love that kind of shit. Oh, what's up, Justin Robert Young?
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Somebody spit on my mama's dick.
Somebody Bilderberg. Skip, bap, beep, boodle, deep, doodle, do. Nope. 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 I don't have sex. What? Oh, geez. 4chan raided her stream and she's not happy. Yeah.
Really? You're banned. Fuck you. You're banned. Fuck you! Fuck you, troll. Fuck you, Zahid. I don't have sex, Pappy. Oh. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I quit having sex a long time ago. I stopped having sex once I realized what men truly were. Worthless.
Mitsula, tell you what, if you want to call in during the show...
Sex was out of a fucking favor for you!
All right, yes. Yeah, we get it. She has a meltdown. When it comes time to joining us on the show, Mr. Mitsula, I'm going to open up the old NSFW show line. Or you could call it Night Attack Show. That'll be open the whole show long. We don't need to... You're not going to be taking calls anyway.
High as fuck. What?
Somebody pull off there!
Easy cheese explosion. Got it. Why not? Justin, I don't think we've brought it on the show in a long time. It's always lived in the pre-show, but I feel like we might have to visit this in the first segment here.
Okay.
It's
Jesus, the loaves and fishes miracle reveal?
Yes. It's only like a minute and a half long, so I figure we'll just take a look see. Let's see.
My favorite part about that is I have no idea where he really is.
Yeah, for all you know he's in Los Angeles. Where
No. I mean no, like as a human. Like I don't know, like if that's designed to be funny. Then like,
oh, it's brilliant, right? Where he's got his own tagline and he builds it up higher every single time. Yeah. By the way, I've got some information. We got the early the early info from Mitsula. He sent it just to me because he didn't want to skew your expectations.
Yeah.
By knowing what he's predicting. And here, I guess I'm gonna set up this webcam.
I guess that's an element I hadn't thought of.
I
mean, like, well, it's like knowing it. But then again, like, you know, I feel like if there's one thing is, you know, I can be trusted to be honest about answering answers, right?
Well, but how you honestly feel at that moment can be affected by
what people think of me.
Yeah, right? It's like, it's a feedback loop in there. By the way, did you see the amazing graphics for this week's MC Allergy themed?
Oh my god, Night Attack Dog. That's fucking amazing. Dude.
Yeah.
Now give me a one to ten. Where are you at boner scale on that picture of Bonnie lounging by the fire in her MC Allergy cover?
Yeah. It's unfair, right? Because I've seen what 11 looks like. You know, I have seen Bonnie the sexiest she's ever been.
And yes, the most but you've probably also seen Bonnie the least sexy she's ever been, right?
Well, touche. That's a good point. Man, I don't know. I feel like this is a trap.
Wait, really?
Well, yeah, I feel like whatever I say, if Bonnie hears it, I'm going to be in trouble.
All right. Well, then I apologize.
God damn, these are great. Good images. Thanks again. Is it Carl that usually puts together the doc? Oh shit! Did you watch the couch gag? The Simpsons couch gag?
I did. Yeah, it's funny.
We watched it earlier. I kind of want to just. R_R and mech. So I don't know if you saw in Cord Killers, this all came about because.
God, look at the baby one! Oh my God, Morty! You killed the entire Simpsons, Morty. They're a beloved family, Morty. They're a national treasure, and you killed them.
I'm just a kid. I don't want to go to jail.
Relax, Morty. Calm down. We'll take care of it. Okay, so, I want you to take that vial of Simpsons goo and this picture.
Apparently, this all happened because Justin Roiland,
right?
Yeah, wanted to ask some of the Simpsons animators to do audio commentary on their DVD, on Rick and Morty DVD. And then once he contacted Matt Groening, and then it was just this massive love fest. They're like, "Are you good? No, that's a great idea. That's a great idea. And we love your stuff." And it's like, "Hey, you know what you should do? You should do a couch gag." And then they got it all worked out with the powers that be. And you got the biggest, most extended. You got basically a 2.5 minute episode of Rick and Morty.
Yeah. No, it's fucking. It's funny. I don't know. I haven't really gotten into Rick and Morty, so I guess like.
Oh, you haven't?
Oh, no.
Okay. All right. Let me just. This is your. Here.
Just realize that this is probably the least likely time I will find this funny.
Okay. No, that's fine. This is. I'm just gonna let it stand on its own. Here's my pitch. This is what the show is. It's yeah.
Achoo. Huh? Seems like TV from other dimensions has a somewhat looser feel to it.
Yeah, it's got an almost improvisational tone. It's in theaters now, coming this summer. Two brothers in a van, and then a meteor hit. And they ran as fast as they could from giant cat monsters. And then a giant tornado came. And that's when things got knocked into 12th gear. A Mexican armada shows up with weapons made from tomatoes. And you better bet your bottom dollar that these two brothers know how to handle business. In Alien Invasion Tomato Monster Mexican Armada brothers, who are just regular brothers running in a van from an asteroid and all sorts of things, the movie. Hold on, there's more. Old women are coming, and they're also in the movie, and they're gonna come and cross attack these two brothers. But let's get back to the brothers, because they have a strong bond. You don't want to know about it here, but I'll tell you one thing. The moon, it comes crashing into Earth, and what do you do then? It's two brothers, and they're gonna... It's called Two Brothers. Two Brothers. It's just called Two Brothers.
Holy... yeah, dude. It's like those brief sublime moments all cut out of Harmontown when just shit gets really bizarre. You saw Vin Diesel breakdancing this week, right? What? Am I having... I haven't seen that since... Oh, before you were born. Am I... This doesn't happen to me anymore. No! I was told I was cured! No, I don't do that! I left that life behind!
What? What's happening, man?
I don't... not since we tells the tale to the tomorrow morrow. It's like, this is the before times. No!
Dude, what in the hot fuck is happening?
All goes well. What?
Oh, yeah, all right. Damn. Yep.
There we go.
Now let's eat in the score. Now just throw your hands in the air. And wave them like you just don't care. And if you wanna bust a move of a crush group, somebody say, oh yeah. Oh yeah. And you don't stop of that crush group right till we hit the top.
I am Groot.
Dude, so here's the thing about, like, I feel like breakdancing is something that looks increasingly weird to people who didn't live through the 80s,
dude,
right?
That shit was the jam, though, man. It's like...
It's hard to explain how cool it was.
Well, it's...
But then again, like, it's the same thing where, like, people... You know, you talk to people who lived through the 70s, and they're like, oh, no, we were, like, teenagers in the 70s, and they're like, yeah, fucking, like, Soul Train was, like, the coolest fucking shit on the planet. If you were dancing on Soul Train, you were, like... Fuck, everybody would suck your dick. Like, male, female,
well,
dog,
also,
fucking
it's
mineral.
It's objectively better than now. It's like, what are you going to compare it to? Planking? Is that what you millennials got? Planking? You got
oh,
the,
no, don't,
the Harlem Shake?
Comparison.
You got the Harlem Shake?
Need to, No, Brian, now you've gone full crank. You can't go full crank.
No, it's just objectively better is what I'm saying is all.
No, that's what being a crank is assuming that your life is the best life and all lives afterward are less than.
See, now you're talking my language. We're on the same page now. I'm glad you came around. Let's see. Circuit City on Laserdisc. Let's take a look. Oh, Jesus. Just about. Oh my God, this is amazing.
Push it, click it, press it, flick it, tune it in, turn it on. This is what you watch it on. Any way you work it, integrate your circuit at the city. Circuit City. Come
to the place you're welcome. I fucking remember this.
Oh, no kidding?
Welcome to Circuit City, where
service is state of the art. The future at your fingertips with all the right connections. Punch a key and you can see the new video directions. You can turn your car into an audio star with the one you want for the way you are.
At Circuit City, trained sales counselors are one of the reasons we get higher customer satisfaction ratings than any other specialty home electronics and appliance chain.
A gadget and a gizmo for electric machismo. Some amplitude for the radical dude. We're tuned into your attitude. Come to the place you're welcome. Technology with a heart.
There was a I wish I could remember their names, but they're
dude, how amazing is it that even then
oh my God, it's on a Laserdisc. That was the demo for the Laserdisc.
how amazing is it that like back then the idea of like Circuit City being a plug,
hey Bonnie,
like that like electronics were still a novelty.
Bonnie, I need you to sit there so you can see how much of your body will be visible, which I'm glad you're wearing that shirt. Show everyone your amazing... Huh?
My rad shirt.
just because I want to be able to cut over to me marking answers on the test.
I need to scooch.
You don't have to scooch nowhere. I'm not gonna show it off, and I'm just... I ain't gonna show it off. You know, I ain't gonna give it away. I'm gonna sell that precious...
That precious? Yo, I got that precious.
You know, it's
showing your precious.
What I meant was I was going to sell it dear, like I was going to charge a lot for it, but then I realized I just nouned her vagina as precious.
A story by Sapphire.
You're precious. Okay, so Bonnie, Justin tried to lay a trap for me to ask... Well, first of all...
Oh, fucking Brian! God damn it, you fucking snitch. Like, this is how you handle it, all right? Bonnie, take a look at that picture and tell me on your own lady boner scale what you rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 10.
My lady boner?
Oh, wait, there we go.
Yeah,
there we
by go. The way, your mic's not on.
Oh, okay. Lady boner, as in like...
Yeah, like how good
is
do you
that?
Think you look in
objectively
that picture?
Objectively hot.
Oh, I can't think about anything but, oh yeah, that's after the... baby was born. I got nursing boobs.
Oh,
so,
damn straight you
yeah,
do. Damn,
yeah.
Girl.
I guess, I don't know. I guess that's all right.
But 1 to 10. 1 to 10.
1 to 10? Let's put it at 6.5.
It's exactly where Brian came in at.
That's, really?
Yeah. Yeah, no.
You're
we talked
asshole.
About. God damn it, fuck!
You're
I told you it was a trap!
Asshole.
It would never work!
You were right.
The correct
you were right.
Answer.
You were right. I was wrong. This is why you've been married for fucking a long time and I haven't been married yet.
Okay,
man.
The
answer
lesson learned. Lesson learned.
Is always 9 and above when it comes to your wife.
But I told him the, well, all right.
What?
I mean, nothing. It doesn't matter what I said. That was all pre-show. And what happens in pre-show stays in pre-show.
Right, I fucked up, man. I tell you what. Listen, you told me. You were like, don't go down the fucking Rocky Pass. Fucking there's rocks and goblins there. And I'm like, no, let's go down the Rocky Pass. I'm an idiot. I'm just going to go ahead and fucking... Yeah, so I'm an idiot.
Hang on. This is definitely not Hearthstone, I'm told.
That works.
Soldiers of the Kelvuzak, obey the call of Kelvuzak.
The music's like still going. Fuck.
Right on. It's got that, like, I ain't even mad, bro. All right. I'm going to see, is there anything else? All right, we'll just check this out. We got a, Lord Master Bong sent me something.
The Lord Master Bong?
Wait a minute. Here's
Ring the bells. Lord Master Bong has sent a correspondence.
Here is, it says GMC faux show dick puppet rare/deleted. He lost a bet and it's not even on. It's on Dropbox if you want to see it. Shit, son. Well, fuck it. Thank goodness we have some Britney Spears mental hospital.
I turned my dick into a puppet.
Oh my God.
Look at that, what do you know? I turned my dick into a puppet. I use my hands to make it grow. I use my hands to make it grow. I turned my dick into a puppet.
I don't know if I have 3 minutes.
I feel like that should win a Tony.
I don't know.
And by Tony, I mean a guy that's really into dick puppets.
Oh, no. I think I blow a Tony.
Justin, I think you need to improve your game with your sock puppets here.
That's a fair point. Mm-mm-mm. Oh, Jesus. Talk about dick puppets.
Oh, all right.
Wait, pause it.
What?
Just so everybody's fucking clear, I mean that his actual dick is visible in the thing. Not
yes.
that I have anything
yes.
against Leo Laporte.
Like, it
the last
matter.
Time I tried to make any kind of fucking double entendre around Leo Laporte, it ended up in a fucking video saying Justin talks shit about Leo Laporte. I have nothing negative to say about Leo Laporte at all. I use double entendres all the time, and it just happens that that's my natural instinct when I'm on live stream is to make jokes that happen to be fucking double meanings. So fucking, just so everybody knows, if you want to fucking post something out of context, fucking have it be about anything else, I have literally zero to say. And if somebody posts anything out of context, then you can post this right here. Leo Laporte is a great guy, and I have zero fucking negative to say about
it. Can we do this real quick? When you were here in studio, and we were with Mike TV, and then we started teaching him Hearthstone, and we did the Epic Forever live stream, and then we shut off the stream because our mouths were too loose, and then it was 3 in the morning, and we chattered.
We can't tell this.
We can't?
The point of this, the point of this is that it remains...
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
It was just really funny.
Let's just say this. Here's something that's out in the open. Brian and I have nothing but love for Twit and Leo Laporte. It was an unfortunate situation that we went through, and fucking Brian and I have both privately fucking apologized to him multiple times.
Repeatedly. I mean, here's what I wanted to say. It's just like we're dumb monkeys after demolishing a bottle of Captain Morgan and arguing by committee, like we're cutting the red wire, the blue wire. And the next morning I realized I sent a 2-line email that basically was like, hi, want to talk? And then that's what we got.
Yeah, I mean, the point is this. There's fucking no beef at all. Whatsoever.
It takes two to fight.
It ain't our fucking, like, you know, we got too many friends over there. We have too many fucking good memories. And that's it.
That's how it shall remain, sir.
And it really annoyed me that, like, on Leo's AMA, what, you know, people sent to us, because you were the number one, like, response on there, that, like, somebody was like, oh, I wonder if they'll make up.
What are you doing? I wanted to tell a funny story about drunk people trying to write an email and it being a short email, and you keep talking about this other guy that's not the guy I was talking about. I didn't want to tell that story at all. Stop.
Okay. There we go. Good.
Stop. Okay, so I got to get the cold open. Jesus. I got something randomly labeled.
And for everybody saying let it go, this is what I'm trying to do. I am trying to let it go.
Clearly.
This is the letting it go.
Stop. I'm muting you. I never do this. I will mute you. Stop. Angel Grapefruit Technique. Yeah.
This is my bonus technique, the grapefruit. Normally, you can only get this technique in one of my classes, but I wanted to share this with you because I believe every man should get grapefruited. When you grapefruit your man, it's going to feel as if you are giving him head and fucking him at the same time. No better feeling would he ever get than being grapefruited. So what you need to do is you need to, of course, have a grapefruit. You want to make sure you get the ruby red. It's sweeter and it's easier. If you are allergic to grapefruit or can't use a grapefruit for your medication, you can always use a large navel orange. Now, what you want to do is make sure the grapefruit is room temperature. All you have to do is put it in warm water. Do not microwave it. Do not boil it. Then, once it gets to that temperature, all you need to do is roll it. The reason why you want to roll it is because you want to juice it up a little bit. The juicier, the better. Then what you're going to do is you're going to find the navel. There's two navels to the grapefruit. Once you do that, you're going to place it on the plate, and the navel's on the outside. You want to take a knife, and you actually want to cut one side of that navel off. Now, all this that you're doing, he will not see any of this preparation because I'm going to tell you that a little bit later. It's a trick. Then what you're going to do is you're going to take it to the other side and do the same thing. So you should have a grapefruit that has two sides missing just like this. Now what you're going to do is you're going to put a hole in the middle of the grapefruit approximately the size of your man's penis. Do not make it too big. Do not make it too tight. Just approximate. Then what you want to do is you're going to take the knife midway down and make sure it goes all the way through. All you want to do is make a nice hole in the middle of the grapefruit. Now if you take it and make it too big, that's okay because you can always squeeze your hands like the muscles of your vagina. And if you make it too tight, all you have to do is take your finger and push the flesh back. It's just grapefruit. Now, when you grapefruit your man, he has to be blindfolded. There's no ands.
Holy shit, look at the hole.
If you came to the bedroom with a grapefruit, what is your man going to say? What are you going to do with that?
Justin.
Is it going to burn and all that other thing?
So you don't want fire hose.
So this is what you do. Say, baby, you know what? Tonight, I want to do something a little freakier. I want to suck your dick blindfolded. Your man will blindfold himself if he knows he's going to get some head. So now, your man is in the bed. You have the grapefruit already prepared under the bed. He smelled the citrus in the air. He thinks you have on some new Victoria's Secrets or something. He has no idea. And what you're going to do is be a woman of your word. Now, you have to get his penis erect. So what you're going to do is just suck his dick. That's like you said you were going to do. Once he's nice and erect, what you're going to do is replace the grapefruit.
Did she just not turn her mic off or what?
You're going to twist up and down on his shaft and suck the head at the same time.
Are we allowed to show this?
Brian.
Now, ladies, remember, grapefruit is also a fat burner, so you actually lose weight while you're sucking his dick. Now, once you're doing
this
technique, it feels amazing.
Oh, that's a fucking, that's a Hearthstone emote.
So what you want to tell your man to do is this. Take the blindfold off. He's going to be looking at you like, what the hell are you doing? But he'll never say stop. All he's going to be thinking is, I could have been fucking a grapefruit all these years. And that's the grapefruit technique.
Oh, my gosh.
Dude, we need Angel on the show.
Wow.
I feel like Angel's got wisdom.
She was,
What just happened?
Fucking, Brian, you need to, in fact, shit. I almost feel like it's, you need to watch it on stream.
Okay. And, I like to show me watching. Okay. All right. Got it. I watched the first half and then I, thought it was a good time to run out. Apparently, I missed the best/worst part.
Nope. Yeah. I mean, yes, both. Yes. Yes. And.
Okay.
It's an improv game. Yes. And.
Awesome. Then, in that case, let me see if I can copy this over. Boop, boop, boop. And then turn this up. Let's see if this works over here. Ba, ba, ba.
I did.
All right. So the Bonnie,
the bit was
Brian said, I refuse to fucking rate it. And then I thought I was going to be clever by saying, oh, fuck, whatever you think, Brian thinks. And Brian was right. That fucking, there's no right answer.
Right.
Yeah.
The right answer is that's not really Bonnie. Fucking, this is a facsimile of fucking
and nothing
true beauty.
Could compare to the majestic splendor of the actual Bonnie Brushwood.
Yeah.
And in fact, it's written in our bathroom walls. We have these tablets. It says, you will make no false idols of your wife because her resplendent glory is too much to be contained in photons. All right.
I did like the MC Allergy poster somebody made with the magic. The
the what?
It was like some like.
The Scarlet Witch. Oh, that was last week's. Yeah.
Yeah, that's funny.
The Age of Allergy.
Yeah.
Actually, here, let's go. Okay. Let's get this rolling.
All right, you got it, boss. Jeff Cannata versus.